Welcome to Green Arena. Angola taking on Germany. It's the final day of pool matches. This is Pool B, and Germany with a 3-1 record going against Angola, one of the surprises in the tournament. They're on a 3-1 record as well. And the comparative rankings overall so far, well, Angola ranked one place above Germany, sitting in sixth place, a plus differential of 50 points. Germany in seventh, a plus differential of 32 points. And looking at the statistics between these two teams, Angola scoring more than the Germans, 87 per game versus 78. They're actually rebounding better as well, 40 versus 38. Shooting percentages, 46% each. And there you see the other games to come later in the day in this pool. New Zealand, crucial match against Panama. If New Zealand wins, they go through to the final 16. And Japan, well, they have to topple Spain if they're going to have any chance, and that's a very, very big ask. My name is Bob Monti. With me once again, Jeff Green. And Jeff, an interesting game here. You're looking at the standings there. It's got to be Angola versus Germany to determine who goes through second. Spain is going to finish first. What do you think?
I totally believe that Spain is going to finish first. And I think the Angolans are going to give the Germans a real scare. Dirk Nowitzki, the NBA star for the Germans, is going to have to play exceptional basketball to try and keep this German team together. Because yesterday's performance for Germany was very, very skittish. They didn't look like the team that had dominated in the early round. But, you know, I'm sure they will do it. But Angola, gee, I love the way Angola plays. And as you see there, the team rosters. But Angola, you can't write them off, Bob. You can't write them off for second place.
Indeed not. Dirk Nowitzki, he's the NBA star. He's averaging 19 points a game. He's one of two players in double figures, the other one being number 10, the shooting guard, Demond Green, averaging so far 12 points per game. Angola coming out now. This is a team that's surprising everyone, perhaps not the Africans. Three teams come from the African zone. Angola finished first, then Nigeria, then Senegal, and all three of them have caused major or minor stirs in this championship thus far. Five players hovering around the double-figure mark or better. Cipriano, Joaquim Gomez, Carlos Almeida, Miguel Lotunda, and Eduardo Mingus. So they really share the scoring around. That's something in their favor, Jep.
One of the things that they do is their big men can shoot the three just as good as their guards. And that's the key for Angola, because against the bigger teams, you just don't know who you're going to go out and guard. That's the key for them. They're shooting.
We now will pause for the national anthems from both countries to be played now. Well, the crowd is a little bit sparse here in the Green Arena. It's the early game in the afternoon. Japanese fans staying away. Japan will play later in the day. Exchange of gifts at midcourt. And looking around the pools, well, there are five teams undefeated in Pool A. Argentina leads 4 wins, no losses. Pool B, this one right here, España, 4 wins, no losses. And in Group C, the pool of death, basically, Greece 4-0, Turkey 4-0. Those two teams will meet today to decide who finishes first in Group C. And in Group D, well, the United States coming here, taking this tournament seriously and looking like they might go all the way. Germany starting five, Hamann, Akalaja, and Demon Green at the shooting positions, 2 and 3. And at 4 and 5, Nowitzki, the do-everything man, and Femmerling, the other 7-footer, to round out their lineup. For Angola, Miguel Lotunda, the 34-year-old captain of this team. Almeida and Cipriano, very good shooters from outside. And the big guys, Mingus, number 15, and Joaquin Gomez, number 10. And they have performed so well at the World Champs. The African nations finally getting a bit of consistency into their play. They've always been athletic, very, very talented, but they've tended to go walkabout at crucial times in the game. That has not been the case in 2006. Dirk Bowerman has to find a way to get his players into this game psychologically, mentally, right from the start. A loss here for Germany would be a real upset, but it would also put doubts in the minds of the Germans as they progress through to the round of 16. Alberto Calvajo, he's had a very good tournament. He's got to be happy with the way his team has performed. 1 loss, 3 wins, and they are looking good. In fact, gaining in stature and confidence with each game. 3 referees, you see them there. Balasevic, Kerian, and Noyem of Lebanon. There's about a minute to go before we start the game, and there he is, one of the players, the best on the planet, Dirk Nowitzki. The whole offense revolves around him, and why wouldn't you? But he's got a good supporting cast.
Do you think that the Japanese director locally here loves Dirk Nowitzki and the NBA stars? They get a lot of coverage, both in the press, the print media, and on television, everywhere. The NBA, they just love it here.
Well, Jeff, of course they love it here, and it's good publicity for the game of basketball just to have these guys showing up on the screen. Japan, not a world powerhouse, but they've acquitted themselves so well. They were the host nation, so they got a bid, even though they didn't finish high enough in the Asian zone tournament, qualifying tournament. Because they were hosting the tournament, they've gotten a berth in the 2006 championships. And they played oh so well. Very, very exciting basketball. An unbelievable game last night against New Zealand. They went down by 3 points in the last minute and 25 seconds. Lost the lead after leading by 18 at halftime. And for New Zealand, it was a breath of fresh air, sort of clinging to life, desperate to win that game. And they came back from nowhere to snatch victory from the jaws of defeat, to be a little bit cliched about it. And Japan, well, they have to be heartbroken. Nowitzki, that's not a bandage, that's just his tooth guard. Akalaja and Hamann, the little point guard, fiery little character that he is. And number 10, Demon Green, one of the best three-point shooters that we've seen in the tournament thus far. And Patrick Femmerlin, the other 7-footer, very experienced, 31-year-old. And Gomez for Angola. Miguel Lotunda, he's the veteran, the all-African star. And Olimpio Cipriano, what a fantastically athletically gifted player that man is. Here we go, Germany versus Angola. A mouth-watering clash here. If Germany's not ready for this game, they could be surprised. Jump ball, center court. Game's underway, Germany. Well, they say Femmerling jumped the ball. It hadn't reached its apex. Now, why would he do that? He's 7 feet tall.
Yeah.
Well,
referees sometimes just get a little bit carried away with their jump ball situation.
well, it's become a non-event in basketball. The only jump ball you have now is to start the game. It's sort of a formality. And now we've got a direction arrow that alternates one side then the other throughout the rest of the game. That includes quarter breaks and restarting it after the halftime break. So as I say, it's just a formality now. Angola with possession. Cipriano makes a move, gets a nice look over Dirk Nowitzki. Ball doesn't go down. We'll see if Germany's into the game or whether they're still sort of cruising or smarting after their punishing loss to Spain earlier in the round. Femmerling bouncing in, kicks it out. Okolodja from out beyond the three, can't hit it. One miss each team to start the game.
Well, you can see what the Germans want to do. They want to try and get the ball inside first. Have a look at those options. If nothing's on, kick it back out.
Well, even we saw there Gomez trying to get a pass inside. It was knocked away by the Germans, so a steal, a turnover.
Second player of the game for the Germans. Inside again, back out.
That's interesting. Hamann took the pass up beyond the arc, and he said, well, I can penetrate a little bit. Took one big step inside and knocked it down. Good shooting from him.
Well, he's not shooting the ball well in this tournament, so I think that was a good decision by Hamann to take that just a couple of steps in closer to the basket. Better for your confidence if you're going to knock down a small jumper rather than a large jumper.
Well, if these facts mean anything, listen to this. Spain beat Angola by 10. Spain beat Germany by 21. So put that in your little mental calculator and see if you can come up with some explanation for what might happen today. Femmerling is fouled
by Minguez. I think you'll find number 15, Minguez, was all over him. Gave him just that little shoulder charge there. Nothing in it, really. Femmerling wasn't going anywhere.
Yep, Eduardo Minguez. Such a good game against New Zealand. He was sort of the single-handed destroyer. Demon Green can't get it. The ball knocked high. And that's usually the case. If you can't get two hands on it, spike it high. Nowitzki, jump, shot, fade away. You can't stop that.
That's his standard shot, the fadeaway. The fadeaway jumper. That's his patented shot in the NBA. And he shoots it so well. Turnover. Latonda going down the lane, talking to the referee. He seems to think he got pushed, but
I think that's a little save some face talk from Latonda. He just went too far. He was in the air, no parachute, nowhere to go, no pass on.
Dangerous position to be in the air with no parachute, believe me.
Femmerling back to Nowitzki. Nowitzki, not a real good tournament for him, but he's still scoring about 20 a game.
See, once again, inside out for the Germans.
Inside, Femmerling backs in, spins, little fake, puts it up, easy too, and yeah. Minguez stayed away from him that time.
Yeah, Minguez needed to because, like, Minguez is just so outsized in terms of height and a little bit of a bulk. Femmerling, just too big.
Well, players matching up, talking to the refs, they're trying to get the call. Hamann thought he was elbowed by Latonda, no whistle. In the meantime, the shot is missed. The offensive board, Gomez. Can't hit it, Latonda kicks it out. Cipriano, he'll have a crack. Throws an air ball, but Gomez on the weak side gets an easy putback.
Joaquin Gomez. He's been just a stellar worker on the boards for Angola. And there you see Femmerling going to the lane again with the left hand on Minguez. Now, coach is getting all over the case of Minguez, but Minguez doesn't want to get in that foul trouble.
Well, it's good offense from Germany. They're going to the big guy, Femmerling. That'll take some pressure off Nowitzki. Femmerling can score 8-10 points in the first period here. That gives Angola something else to talk about. Gomez, nice move down the lane and gets the two.
Yeah, it was pretty simple stuff for Gomez. I think the Germans are sort of taking this game too as, well, let's not try and get in too early foul trouble. Let's see how it develops. As we see, Nick Dirk Nowitzki with the three. Look at the expression on his face. That's dangerous for Angola with Dirk getting off so well, because previous games he's been a slow starter. Maybe, you know, three or four shots missed early on.
Well, Nowitzki's such a professional customer. Good rebound. The outlet pass in Germany. Not really forcing the pace. And the foul is on Miguel Latunda, number 14.
Yeah, I think Germany have decided that Angola is such a good team in the open court, good fast-breaking type team, can shoot the three in the open play. They've decided to take the air out of the ball, be very methodical on offense. Let's work the ball inside, then go outside and see how it goes from there. Good strategy by the Germans.
Fade away, Nowitzki can't get it. Mingus, weak side rebound. Angola pushing it up quickly. Inside, Gomez stops, fakes. Reverse layup, gets his own rebound. The man is tireless in there, and he's fouled. So Germany having a little bit of work to do under their own defensive board.
Well, Gomez was all by himself. There was one, two, three, four black jerseys there, and only one white jersey in frame. And that's been the case for Angola the whole time. You know, they have guys that just relentless on the offensive glass. In comes the big man. Musa, number 12, he's another big man that can shoot the three, but is just tireless inside.
And the little man, Barros, the man with a cut above his left eye, he's a fiery little character, number 7 for Angola. So already a few substitutions for Angola. 11-5, 6-point spread early on here. And Gomez has been their offense thus far. He's got 6 points. Angola has 6 points. Germany on 11. Angola playing man-to-man. Nowitzki guarded by Gomez inside to Femmerling. This is good offense from the German team. They're playing the ball inside to Femmerling. They're not concentrating on Nowitzki, the big 7-footer, at the free throw line again. Femmerling already has 4 points. He rims it, bounces out. Well, the Angolan fans putting up a little bit of noise, trying to distract the big fella. Second shot, nothing but. Barros, left alone for just a moment, decides to give it up, and Cipriano finds Almeida. Here's a streak shooter. Goes left, stops, puts it up. It was a good look, just fell short.
Well, Angola, they're not going to go away. I think the Germans' game plan is very, very simple, very effective right now, and it is working for them. But, you know, watch out if the Angolans get a couple of fast breaks. Here they go, pushing the ball, Barros.
Yeah, they've got speed outside. Barros is one of those speedsters. Cipriano, turnaround jump shot, throws air, and it's saved by Musa. Almeida down the lane. Oh, we got the foul. It's going to be against Haman, I do believe.
Well, see, there's another example of the hustle of the big men on the offensive glass. Musa, you would have said that was for all money gone, but he saved the ball, got it back in. Almeida immediately attacked the rim.
4:16 left to play in the first period. Germany jump into a 6-point lead, 12-6 early on here.
Are we basketball?
Watching, Green Arena, timeout taken. Angola chasing Germany, as you see there, 12-6. But as Jeff Green says, I don't think Angola's going to go away. And Germany have come out, well, they're certainly into the ball game. They're not taking this lightly. Dirk Bowerman speaking English.
So you know he's pretty relaxed if he's speaking English, as we've said previously in commentary. When Dirk Bowerman speaks English, the Germans are quite comfortable. When he starts breaking into German, you know that the pressure is on, as we see Dirk Nowitzki. Just so comfortable as a seven-footer shooting the jump shot. 5 years ago, you wouldn't see seven-footers, Bob, in any form of basketball around the world shooting the basketball. Guys like Nowitzki, Gasol, all of those sort of international stars that have come into the game, Bogut, they're all comfortable shooting the three-point shot now, as if it's part of their arsenal.
Well, it sort of revolutionized basketball and how it's thought of and how it's played. When you've got players like Gasol and Nowitzki who are so competent from out beyond the arc as well as able to post up low, it just creates another dimension, if you like, to the game.
Gone are the days where you have a seven-footer and you plant him in the middle of the defense and tell him catch the ball on offense and don't shoot it outside the keyhole. Gone are those days. And the international stars have brought that pressure or brought that new type of player to the international game. And now the NBA have picked up on those sort of shooting stars.
Well, you're dead right. Into the game comes Murray, I think it is. It is, number six. So two point guards into the game. Barros and Murray. Carlos Murray. Nowitzki down low, puts the ball to the floor. Comes across. Well, he's almost impossible to stop in there. Gomez picks up a foul trying to slow him down.
Well, when Nowitzki's in this sort of mood, you don't know whether to look. He's now posting up one step deep into the lane, and it's just a finger roll over the top of the rim. That's the sort of skill that you've got as a seven-footer. Shoot the three, post up, shoot the medium-range jumper, handle the ball, rebound. And as you say, when he's in this sort of form, he's almost impossible to stop.
Well, you see it in his body language. This is a professional who's just come to work, taken off his suit coat, loosened his tie, and he's just going to work. He's on 8 points already, leading scorer in the ball game by a long way. Gomez, little jump hook over Nowitzki,
now
nothing but air.
And as you say, Nowitzki now showing his defensive prowess. He forced Gomez into a near ball.
Nowitzki on the floor, goes to the hoop, the left-handed hook this time. Gomez did a good job staying with him. Just put the shot off slightly. Angola need to score. They're down 15-8. 3:22 left in the first period. Nice drive to the hoop. Olimpio Cipriano. There's a certain rhythm to that name.
When that man touches the ball and decides to go down the lane, there's only one thing you can do is foul him. And Patrick Femelin, that's the only thing he could do. Foul him. He fouled the wrong hand as well, Patrick Femelin. Cipriano put the ball into his right hand. Femelin fouls his left.
That boy can fly. A lot of hang time there, Cipriano. So athletic. A very talented 24-year-old. Nowitzki inside Femerling. The spin doesn't work. Brings it back high. And he kicks it out. Akolaja can't hit it. And Cipriano on the break. One on three. Then he pulls up.
That's what Angola want. They want to get the ball out in the break and break people down one-on-one, as Cipriano just did. The Germans will need to talk about it because their game plan offensively is great, but defensively, the Angolans are just taking them apart.
Well, 2:52 left in the first period, and Germany has taken a timeout. They lead by two now, 15-13, and ominously, Patrick Femelin was limping as he came off the court. Angola on a 5-0 run here in the late minutes of the first period, getting straight back into the ball game, and Germany having to call a timeout to settle their team down and try to work out what to do defensively against players like Cipriano. Well, the field goal percentage is there, 31 versus 46%. Angola, doesn't matter. They don't want to shoot that for the whole game, but right now they're only 2 points behind, so they haven't been punished too badly from poor shooting. That's because they've got five free throws, 5 of 5 from the charity stripe, 2 of 3 for Germany.
You know that the foreign press here in Japan is just so interested in African basketball. Every press conference, Coach Cavallo has asked the same question. How many teams are there in the Angolan Professional League? You know, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So everyone is just so interested, because they've done so well, what happens in African basketball. I can tell you, there's 11 teams, and Coach Cavallo coached the winning championship team in their national league this year.
Fund of information, as usual, Jeff Green. Mitat Demiral now at point guard for Germany, and Robert Garrett into the ball game. Schulze as well goes to the hoop. Nice running left-hander. That guy's got talent. He's a big body, Schulze. He stands 2.08 meters tall. A lot of weight. 28-year-old. He's not a youngster. Musa from the baseline over Nowitzki. Akalaja throws it away.
Moraes gets it. Gets it back. Cipriano again. Look at the quickness.
Oh, he just blows past Okalaja on the baseline. And Garrett reaching in against Gomez at the top commits a foul. Femmerling on two fouls. He's on the bench at the moment. He limped off during that half, that break. And I just wonder if he strained a knee or something. Schulze replacing him. 6'10" replaces 7 foot. That's not bad.
It's a pretty good substitution.
Cipriano against Okalaja. The foot speed difference you see there. He went around Okalaja as though Okalaja was still had the handbrake on.
Well, Okalaja knows that he's got a great defensive assignment. And unless he stops it, the Cipriano Express leaves the three-point line every 30 seconds. Going to the hole.
Well, Angola shooting 72% over four games from the free throw line. 73% from Germany. Both teams pretty handy from the free throw stripe. Shooting percentages overall, well, 46% each. On 3 points, pretty close again. 40% for Angola, 39% for Germany. And the lucky run from the charity stripe continues. 7 of 7 for Angola. That's keeping them in this game. 2 points behind Germany. Waning moments here in the first period. Garrett.
Well, Germany continuing with that game plan, slowing the ball down, kicking it inside first, looking, nothing there, kicking it back out. Pretty good, effective game plan. Now they'll try and stop the Angolans from penetrating and getting easy baskets, easy looks.
And Carlos Murray looking inside. The bounce pass, a little tough to handle for Musa.
Well, it was around Musa's ankles, so the big man isn't going to stoop that low to try and get it.
Nowitzki finds Demiral, the little point guard. Now hits Green. Green has the ball knocked away from him. Cipriano has it taken right away from him. Two lackadaisical going for that ball.
He traveled.
Steps called.
Yeah. That call. The referees here in Group B have been very, very consistent calling that.
Well, in theory, your pivot foot should not be lifted until the ball hits the court. It's a tough call to make, but it's been blown against a couple of teams here. Musa kicks it out to Cipriano. A little fake into the corner. Oh, nice working it inside, and Gomez draws a foul. Schulze comes over and belts him. Not with malice aforethought, however. Trying to block that shot.
Just a hard foul. But it was good little sort of ball play between the Angolan players. Normally they would have settled for the outside three. A couple of ball fakes there. A couple of good little passes, interchanges. Gomez wasn't quite able to convert it, and he misses the first.
Well, that's the first missed free throw for Angola. 19-16, under a minute to play in the first period. Time running down here. Demerl goes down out front. He takes steps as he hit the deck. Both feet were in the air as he slid across the floor. And that's called walking. Turnover goes Angola's way. 42 seconds. And Angola could level it here with a three or seriously cut into the lead with a two. Cipriano against Garrett. Okolodze has been taking out. Just couldn't stay with Cipriano from the top. Nowitzki. Oh, he's a do-everything man. Every time something positive happens for Germany, you can bet Nowitzki's got a hand in it somewhere. He started it or finished it or directed it. He'll put the ball on the floor and come high. 3.5 seconds. Well, after all that time thinking about his options, he said, why not take the easy one?
Well, nothing was happening. No one was cutting. And when you've got a player of that caliber that can do that sort of thing, it's pretty easy offense.
So at the end of 10 minutes of play, Germany on that two-pointer from Nowitzki go into a five-point lead, 21-16 over Angola. Here are some of the highlights, opening period. Cipriano, he's so quick off the dribble, penetrates the German defense behind the lines and gets the two. Nice move, Olimpio Cipriano, and now watch Nowitzki. That's it, the last shot of the first period, looking for somebody cutting, there was nothing happening, so he said, well, given that sort of choice, I'll have the two, and he took it. He's got 10 points already in double figures, first period. Is it English or German, Jeff?
Well, he's very calm as we look at some of the statistics. Angola, surprisingly, 0 for 6 from the three-point line. It's unbelievable. But more, just as surprising, too, is that Germany are only 1 and 3. But look at the rebounding edge that Angola has. 5 offensive rebounds. But that just shows the straight hustle of their big men. Minguez, Gomez, Musa. They're all very, very tough on the offensive glass.
Well, another factor that didn't show up there is Angola has scored 8 points off 9 free throw attempts. Germany's only been at the line 3 times. Well, had 3 attempts. They've made 2. So free throws and second chance opportunities keeping Angola in the game here. 5-point spread, second 10 minutes of play, ready to go. Barros, sporting that bandage over his left eye, comes out and he's tracking, hunting down Demerl. Schulze, Femmerling back in the game. We'll see what his knee is like. Oh, he looks all right to me, no problem. A little bit of a strain that I saw just in the first period is not there, and Sergeant Schulze knocks it down.
Schulze, what a great little turnaround jumper.
Well, you got to remember, this is another guy who's 6'10", 2.10 meters tall, big, big body. Barros making a move against Demerl, pulls up. Threw a brick on the glass. Shot clock expires. Germany with possession. Now Angola under a little pressure here. They've slipped back 7 points in arrears of Germany. Cipriano almost gets a steal. Well, Germany can't relax, Jeff. No, Angola, quick.
I think they've got the right game plan to... They really have just taken the wind out of the sails, and we wish we had some wind here in Hiroshima at the moment, but they've taken the wind out of the sails of the Angolans. They're just trying to keep them down slow, keep them without running the ball. That's the key for the Germans. And I think they've got the right game plan. It's working right now.
Demon Green from out beyond the arc can't score it. And the German shooting, which was so exceptional against New Zealand, just hasn't been the same since.
0 of 6 from the three-point line.
That's a bit surprising. Barros working against Demerol. A little bit of a mismatch there, and he goes inside, and he's foot-tripped by Demerol, who's claiming Barros put an elbow in his chest. And this happens every time there's a whistle. There's always this little discussion.
Well, let's have a look. Well, Demerol's saying that he actually hooked him. But I don't think it was an outright hook. He did have an elbow attached around, but he didn't have the rest of his arm extended.
Well,
so
the case for the defense failed. Guilty is charged, so Demerol picks up a foul. Oh, nice move to the hoop by Green. Nice body control, but it just refuses to drop. Lady Luck not smiling on the Germans. Nowitzki on the bench. At the moment, he was up on his feet. I'm sure he'd like to be in the ball game. Germany struggling now offensively. They don't have that go-to guy, that automatic shot. Nowitzki provides him with so much confidence. Gomez can't hit it. Garrett igniting a fast break. No, Germany slowed down.
Yeah, no, that a fast break, unless they're going to get a lap, you won't see Germany on too many fast breaks tonight.
Garrett over the outstretched hands of Musa. Ball is kicked back high, and Germany pick it up. That resets the shot clock. 23-16. A bit of an arm wrestle right now. 2.5 minutes have been played. 2 points have been scored. Germany lead 2-0 in this period. Demerol from out beyond the arc.
Well,
another miss.
This is unbelievable shooting from the Germans. Unbelievable in that they haven't hit anything from the outside. 0 of 8 now.
Cipriano off the glass. Couldn't get it down. He gets a good look. He's got such good hang time. Probably could have made a little bit more of that. Green.
Well,
there we go.
Damon Green improves the statistical shooting. 1 for 9 for Germany from the three-point line. More importantly, builds a 10-point lead. And as the lack of scoring shows, Nowitzki will be coming into the next break. But Barros answers. Says, so we're back to that 7-point lead again.
That's right. Anything you can do, I can do better. Smack. At the other end, the ball hanging on the ring, and Musa got a hand to it, just kept it from dropping in, and then pulled down the rebound. Once the ball hits the iron, it's in play, so the defender can go up and knock it away. Almeida, nice little pass to Musa. Spins, and it's blocked by Femmerling. Back into the hands of Angola.
Cipriano,
there we are.
Athletic as, just going to the basket, as we know he can. And just throws in a lovely little shot inside the keyhole.
Atletico Olimpio Cipriano. Femmerling, nice little fake, puts it up, but he's chopped, and he'll get a couple of free throws. Nowitzki and Hamann coming back into the game for Germany, replacing Demerol and probably Garrett. Timeout taken, 5:42 left to play in the second quarter. Germany sitting on 26, Angola chasing, they're on 21. .26-21 points in the paint thus far. Angola 10, Germany 8. It was pretty clear from the opening couple of minutes that Germany wanted to go inside. They kept looking inside for the seven-footer, Patrick Femmerling. And that was pretty successful early on. But actually, Angola has outscored them in that area of the game. Shooting percentages, well, 1 of 9 for Angola from beyond the arc, 2 of 6 for Germany. Highlights, Demon Green. There's one of those two, knocks it down. And Cipriano is a classy player, as he shows there. Once he's in the air, he seems to be able to move laterally. I don't know how he does it. Great hang time. And for Deutschland, here comes Dirk Nowitzki. A daunting sight. If you had to mark this man, you saw him getting off the bench. You just heave a big sigh and pull up your socks and say, right, okay, the next 10 minutes are going to be tough. Patrick Femmerling, 5 points, trailing Nowitzki, who's on 10. And for Angola, the leading scorer at the moment, Gomez on 7, and Cipriano on 9 points. One of two, 27-21, 6 point lead. Carvalho into the game. Antonio Carvalho, now he's one of the veterans, 37 years old. He's played very, very well in patches. Little fake, and he tries to draw the foul. There was no whistle. He'll have a word with the referee as he goes up the court.
Well, I think it was just good defense by Demon Green. He knew he got sucked in, so he sort of twisted his body away from the offensive player.
Okolaja tries to kick it out, and Barros, or was it... Almeida. Almeida signals thumbs up to the referee. He knew he was caught. Guilty as charged, sir. His 27-21. Angola staying with Germany, but just not having the offensive consistency to get their noses in front. Okolaja takes a little jump, could have been steps. Nowitzki drives, puts the ball in the air. He's looking for the foul. He wasn't happy with the lack of a call.
He gave a long stare to the referee. Now Dick Bowman,
still looking at him,
helps his player out by questioning the referee as well.
And Barros is fouled in the air. He says, I'll just hang on to the ball. It'll save a little extra time. So he doesn't even try to pass it. Watch this. Whack, there. So he just hangs on to it. Germany had him boxed in and defended. He's lucky he got the call, Jeff.
Yeah, well, Demon Green, he didn't protest it. Barros just too quick for him offensively.
Milton Barros, number 7. Carvalho, the veteran, number 9. Almeida, he's a real streak shooter. Good defense from the Germans. They're really putting pressure on Angola outside. Angola really struggling to get a good look at the basket. Offensively, what are they going to do?
Well, it's because the Germans have got them in this half-court set. And the Angolans, the only thing they've got off their half-court set is a drive to the basket. Because the German defense is playing good half-court defense. Mengus
kicks it out. 5 seconds on the shot clock.
And that's the key, Bob. The German defense is just so good in the half court, and Angola can't get into that running game. They can't get into the open looks that they love to do. Perfect game plan to date for Germany.
Yes, it is. So Germany, a chance to extend their lead. We've got 4 minutes left to play in the first half. Germany not ahead by a lot of points, but they're certainly looking tougher and tougher as the minutes go on here. Angola. Oh, nice spin dribble for Okolaja. He spun through two players, went to the hoop, and got an easy two.
That was very nice, very nice. A lot of his teammates acknowledged that nice move, getting off the bench to clap it.
Well, he's another real veteran, Okalaja, 31-year-old.
Oh, Barros comes back with a three, deep, deep three as well.
Harmon gives it up to Femmerling. Okalaja. In it goes. Femmerling, another veteran player. Harmon, a ball spiked against the glass by Musa. Angola protect the rim pretty
See,
well.
See, once again, they're out in the open court. That's what they like to do.
The following attempted putback.
They'll tag Musa. Yes, they have. They'll tag Musa. Bit too aggressive. Abdel Aziz Musa. That's his third foul. That's Barros going to the lane. And Dirk Nowitzki thought he had an easy off defensive board.
Oh, he was muttering something about the sky is falling as he fell to the floor. 29-24.
I'm surprised Musa's still in the game.
Yes, interesting stage of the game. A lot of time for Musa to pick up that fourth foul. I certainly don't want that.
Oh, patented move by Okalaja. He just loves that little jump hook from around the key, in and around the keyhole. Lovely little jump hook.
Well, that's an interesting situation now. The Germans have two or three players who sort of share the burden. If Nowitzki's not on, then it might be Femmerling or Garrett. In this case, it's Okalaja. Nowitzki, you see him pounding down the floor, gives it up to one of the guards, thinks better of trying to get around Barros. Harmon kicks it out. Okalaja. We got a charge. Yep. He had a gleam in his eye, and the ref had a pee in his whistle.
Barros was well set. And Okalaja, Duke Bellman's just saying to him, we don't need to get into that quick shot offense. Because look, Barros was there well before anyone even thought of doing anything.
Well, that's called putting your body on the line for country, for home, for club, for the glory of Angola. 31-24, still a 7-point lead here to Germany. Carlos Murray at point guard for Angola. Inside it goes, and Okalaja fouls at the other end, comes down, and within 10 seconds has a second foul pasted next to his name.
So that'll be his third foul for Okalaja. Gomez had him sealed down low for a long, long time. Barros didn't see him. In comes the shooter, Damon Green.
Well, another very low-scoring contest here, 31-24. There's 2 minutes to play in the first half, and Germany certainly not putting Angola away. Angola struggling to get a little offensive continuity. Tough matches here. Murray, ball has a life of its own, mind of its own. Gomez.
Oh,
scoop shot. Gets his own rebound. Weak
what
side.
A good
He's got
move.
It.
Gomez. That was a pretty little move that he did on Femmerling in the first place. And then he came under the basket to grab his own offensive rebound. This is a pretty move. This is unfortunate. It didn't go in. But he still had the presence of mind to attack the basket, get the offensive rebound. Easy two in the end.
1:41 left to play in the first half. Timeout taken as Germany talk things over, leading Angola 31-26. The winner of this game will finish second in this pool, so there's importance riding on the outcome. If you finish second, you play the third place finisher in the crossover game. If you finish third, well, you get the second best team from Pool A. So both teams would love to play the weaker team in the other division. That means finishing second. Okalaja, look at the spin dribble between two players. He actually carries the ball right there. Referees don't call it. The result, an easy two.
Look at Barros, though. Comes back with the three down the other end. Not the smoothness that we see from the Angolan shooters normally.
Little jump hook.
That's the little jump hook. Now, Okalaja That's his patented move. The little jump hook in the lane.
Dirk Bowerman sounding pretty composed in this timeout as Germany hanging on to a 5-point lead.
Well, the German fans there, they don't seem too enthusiastic about the effort right now. Haven't heard the Angolan fans, they're normally quite active.
Gomez shooting two. The team shooting 8 out of 9 from the line. Gomez, 3 of 4 so far. Free throws count. Free throws win ball games. I know that's trite, but it's very, very true. And Angola doing pretty well in that category right now. So that turned that 2-point putback into a 3-point play. And Schulze comes in for Germany, replacing Femmerling. Demerl at point guard. And Nowitzki, the big man, playing offense everywhere, anytime, all the time. Green inside, Nowitzki. Mingus setting himself, reaching in, trying to stop the big fella. Schulze saves it, but it goes to Barros, and he tries to motor around Demerl, who reaches in and fouls him.
Well, Demerl knows the game plan for Germany. Don't let the Angolans get into the open court. Stop every fast break opportunity. We've got 3-point guards. There's 15 fouls among them. Let's try and stop them. 2 fouls for Demerl, but good strategy. The Germans sticking to the game plan.
Barros trying to put some of that shirt somewhere.
Don't players just love playing with their shirts out, and the referees constantly remind them, tuck your shirt back in.
Well, a little distraction, fiddling around with his attire. He misses the free throw. 9 of 11, Angola in the first half. 31-27, 4-point spread, and 1 minute and 19 seconds left to go in the first half. Could be a crucial last 60 seconds here. 3-point ball game, Germany with possession. A stop here would do Angola's chances a heap of good. Green trying to get Schulze inside, nothing there. The kick back to Nowitzki. Bounce coming over the top. Free throw line into the corner. It's picked off by Barros, who's up quickly.
Demerl shut him down, though. Demerl shut the fast break down. Exactly what Germany want.
Well, it's one of the features of every game. The little point guards, they're doing their job. They're sort of hyperactive out there. And Morey misses, almost an air ball. Green inside. Nowitzki left all alone. He blew his shot, gets his own rebound, and puts it back up.
And he knocks two Angolan players down just for good measure.
And he had a few words to say to the referee about that missed call on the shot, he thought. Murray. 33-28. We're down to 8 seconds. Now they make their move. Barros down the lane as the ball raked out of his hands by Demerl.
It's really interesting. If you watch guys like Nowitzki, Pau Gasol was doing it the other night as well. The NBA players always look up to the center scoreboard in the middle of the court because they're so used to having these big scoreboards showing replays and time and clock and all that sort of thing. He just looked up to see how much time was on the clock, and he had to sort of look around to the basket. It's really interesting how they're used to something like that, so simple, and yet they just don't have it here.
I thought some of them were looking skyward for guidance, Jeff. Barros makes his first. Good free throw shooting continues from Angola. We've got a 3-point spread. Now there's 4.8 seconds on the board. Hamann comes in, the point guard. There's plenty of time for Germany to make one, possibly two passes, get a good look, and knock down a 2-pointer. Demerl over halfway. Gives it to Nowitzki, who turns and launches one. Now that was a good look from 3 meters above the arc, but it misses. It falls just short. So at the end of 20 minutes of play, Germany surprisingly clinging to a three-point lead over Angola. One of the tournament surprises. It's a 33-30 break at halftime. Angola have to be happy with their first half performance. Germany, well, they're playing to a pretty good game plan, but Angola is not going to go away. As Jeff Green said, Nowitzki's got a lot of work to do in the second half, and Coach Dirk Bowerman talking to him as they walk off the court. The German fans enjoying the tournament here. Pool B matches in Hiroshima. And a very confident, very happy Angolan team leave the court at halftime, trailing by a mere 3 points against superpowers Germany. Checking the stats, Germany shooting 50% versus 33 on the twos. Look at the threes, 2 of 7 for Germany, 2 of 12. Not particularly good from either team. Free throws, that's keeping Angola in the game. They've only missed two. Rebounding, that has evened up. 7 offensive boards for Angola. That tells a little bit of a story. They've gotten several putbacks off offensive boards. Germany will not be happy with that. Game leaders, Gomez 10, Musa the leading rebounder. And Nowitzki's headed for another double-double. 12 points, 5 rebounds. Barros with 3 steals. The hyperactive guard plays so well for Angola out front. And top scorers, Gomez 10, Barros 9. Cipriano had a great start to the game. He's on 9. Nowitzki 12, Femmerling 6, Schulze 4, Okalaja 4. Germans sharing the scoring around very, very well at this stage. And if we look at the German shot chart, you see there's a lot of shots coming from the right side of the court as you face the basket, a few underneath. And they've had a few misses, especially out around the three-point line. They won't be happy with that. They'll try to improve on that in the second half, obviously. And for Angola, well, under the basket, that's what's kept them in the game. You see the cluster of green dots there.
Look at all those red dots around the outside, though, for Angola. That's highly unusual, all those misses from around the three-point line. And that's because the German defense is just keeping their running game at bay.
Well, it's a halftime break here. Germany have gone into the break leading by 3. It's a 33-30 spread over Angola.
Here's the highlights as we look at them here. Germany started off pretty well. Angola were very tough on the inside. But the German game plan was pretty simple. Get the ball inside, work it. If it's not on, kick it out.
Well, Cipriano, isn't he a delight to watch? Antonio Carvalho, the coach, exhorting his player to even greater heights. Cipriano, so athletic. Well, you don't have to say who that is. We know. He's a maverick, this man. Turnaround jumper, Schulze, that's a 6'10" player, takes the pass, spins in the air, and nets it. Barros rains one in from outside. You get a good shot at it, of it, and it's perfect. Okalaja spin dribbles between two players, goes to the glass for the easy two. Barros once again, splash. And Nowitzki, well, he just sticks with it until the job is done, and then he registers his complaint. in the sternest of terms. So at the halftime, Germany lead Angola by 3 points. It's close. The 20 minutes coming up will tell who goes through in second place. Will it be Angola or will it be Germany?
Thank you. better today.
Angola getting ready to start the second half. They played so well in the first half. They're down by 3 points. Couple of interesting stats. Angola shooting 27% overall. Germany shooting much better at 45%. But from the free throw line, Angola have made 12 of their 14 free throw attempts. 3 of 5 for Germany. That's the reason why there's just a 3-point differential between these two teams. Biggest lead of the game. Germany with 10 points. Well, Angola haven't led at all. Points in the paint, pretty well even. 14 Germany, 12 Angola. That's a bit of a surprise. But here we go, the last 20 minutes of this ball game to decide who it is that's going through second in Pool B. Both teams sitting on a 3-win, 1-loss record. Spain leading, of course, with a 4-1, 4-0 record. They play Japan later today. Mingus from a long way out misses the first shot, and a couple of Angolan players, Cipriano and Gomez, bump into one another and mess up the rebound. Goes over to Germany. And right away, as they did to start the game, they go down low to Femmerling, backing in, kicks it out. Hamann, baseline, back to Femmerling. Femmerling drives, nice move from the big guy, and he misses a shot. Had a good look.
He had a great look, and Angola tried to push it out quickly, but the German transition defense is up to the task.
Down low to Gomez. Femmerling comes around, almost gets the steal. Gomez backing in. Jump shot, a little fadeaway, doesn't go down, and is knocked out of bounds by Dirk Nowitzki, who takes his case to the court.
He was very upset with that. From our camera angle here, I thought Mingus had knocked it out, but the referee was a lot closer than me.
Barros.
Plus, he's more important than I am, Bob.
He's got a whistle. That's one thing, Jeff. You're right. Murray takes it down the lane, and he stays in the air. He sort of double pumps the ball. He brings it down, puts it back up in trouble. He draws the foul, so he'll be on the line right there. Green hits him on the wrists. Can the free throw shooting, the good free throw shooting at 86% clip, continue in the second half for Angola? Hold your breath. Angola score first, and we've got a 1-point ball game. Would you believe it? Germany just clinging to a 1-point lead here over Angola. The surprise in Pool B, the World Championships 2006. They're making believers out of everyone. Green comes high, can't buy a basket from outside. Germany not particularly happy out there. 2 of 8, 3-point attempt. Cipriano corner. Hamann on the run, gives it to Garrett. Oh! Cipriano with a big spike.
Well, there was a volleyball tournament here during the weekend, so Cipriano came straight from the volleyball tournament, spiked that.
Whoa.
What a great defensive play.
This boy can jump, but Angola give it up straight away at the other end. Very generous indeed, giving it straight back to Germany underneath. Gomez knocks it away from Femmerling. And the game poised right now. Germany haven't been able to get untracked offensively. And 2 minutes have expired. In the third period, Germany hasn't even looked like scoring. Only two free throws from Angola. An air ball from Demont Green. Down low, Gomez in the paint. And the foul from behind, Femmerling.
That'll be his third. That'll be his third. So we've got Demerol, Okolaja, Femmerling on three fouls for the Germans.
Schulze will be coming in to replace him. Here he comes now. Femmerling on his third foul. Bought a ticket to the bench. He'll ride the pine for a few minutes, probably most of this third period. They'll need him in the stretch if it's a close ball game. Murray goes left. Jump shot. Nice fadeaway from the baseline. Just couldn't put it down. And Nowitzki gets the rebound. Nowitzki leading scorer in the game on 12 points. Five rebounds to go along with those points. Hamann comes off the pick. Kicks it out into the corner. Garrett. They're so patient, the Germans, on offense. Oh, look at that. The reach in.
Look at the expression on Barros's face. He really did think he had that one. Let's have a quick look at it here. He did reach across the body, and I suppose that's what the referee's saying. Well, you did reach across the body.
Well, it's like a little boy sneaking an extra cookie
yep.
in the kitchen. Mother caught him. He gets the foul. Nowitzki from the top of the key. Can't buy a basket, and Gomez up there just making sure it didn't go in, taps it off the iron. Murray, spin dribble, and he's called for the charge.
And I think Murray there pulled a foul, and he's looking around saying, yeah.
Well, technically, the defensive player has to be stationary. They has to arrive at the spot and be absolutely stationary to get the call.
I thought Hamann reacted there, and that was nowhere near a foul.
Another thespian award dished out. Hamann this time. Green looking underneath for Schulze. Cross-court pass. Garrett has a very, very good look and rims it in and out. The little Tanifa pucks it out of the basket. Call it a gremlin, leprechaun, whatever you like, or in Maori, Tanifa. Spin dribble, back high, and Barros moving it around. Cipriano on the baseline. So athletic, that man, Jeff.
Nowitzki worried him out of that shot, got the defensive rebounds, come down, puts it up. Well, both teams have gone cold.
Yeah, Nowitzki cold now too. Cipriano misses the shot. Once this guy is in the air, he seems to be able to change direction. I know it's impossible, but you watch him. He's just brilliant. Mengus against Schulze down low. Backing in. Has to kick it out. Gomez from the three-point line throws air. Angola a chance to go into the lead. Germany still haven't scored. We played 4.5 minutes in the third period. Well, this is a trench warfare classic.
Morey gets another foul. That's the second. He had to stop the German fast break because down the other end, Dirk Nowitzki was posted.
Substitutions coming in for Angola. Almeida and Lotunda, the captain, number 14. He hasn't been in the ballgame for quite some time. Almeida, a streak shooter, if he can get a good look at the three, and Lotunda, he too is very, very good shooter out beyond the arc. Nowitzki on the baseline. Just puts up the jumper. He's got it. It's the second time he's done that.
Yeah, he's just got the ability to make a shot out of nothing because Germany had nothing there once again.
Well, he waited patiently for the cutters. Nobody was doing anything, so he put it up himself. Schulze tips the ball to Nowitzki. Fast break. Nice pass underneath. Okolaja polishes it off, and Germany with four unanswered points. rip into a five-point lead. It was a one-point ball game two blinks ago. Angola need to score to stem the tide here. Almeida from a long way out. And Germany a chance to go even further into the lead if they score on this possession.
Once again, very deliberate in their offensive execution, Germany. Inside-outside game.
Well, there's a mismatch. Mingus working against Nowitzki. Mingus doing a good job, but he's giving away at least 7 centimeters and a lot of weight as well. Probably more in terms of height. Almeida against Green. Cipriano from outside. And Angola's gone cold. There's ice in the bucket. 4 minutes just under to play. Mitet Demirel misses the shot. Now Angola, a little bit more deliberately, come over halfway. They need two.
But this is great if you're a German fan because of the fact that they've got Angola exactly where they want them in a half-court game. They haven't got that run-and-gun style going, and they really have to work on their half-court offense as Mingus converts a somewhat lucky shot, shall we say.
That's one of the toughest shots in basketball. You're so deep on the baseline from the side that you're looking back in court to see the basket. It's a very, very bad angle to shoot the ball, but Mingus knocks it down. Mingus commits his second foul. We've got a timeout taken. Angola with 3:15 left in the third period. Germany leading by three. It's a 37-34 ball game. It's a tight one here at the Hiroshima Sports Center. And the score in the third quarter is 4 each. Angola top scorers, Gomez on 10, two players on 9, Barros and Cipriano for Germany, Nowitzki 14, Femeling Okolaja on 6 each, and we're able to keep appraised of the scores in the other pools, and here's quite a surprising one. From Pool A, Serbia and Montenegro leading Argentina 59-54 in the third period. Slovenia having the edge over China, 45-38. Lots of upsets as we're moving after today into the final 16. Garrett, in the highlight, has his shot pasted against the glass. Nowitzki, well, he waits patiently. There's no offensive movement, nobody coming off picks. So he does what he always does. He drops a two. Well, it was 33-30 at halftime. That means Angola's scored 4, Germany has scored 4, and 7 minutes have elapsed in the third period. Talk about low-scoring basketball. That's a standoff. Whoever blinks first could get blown away. Well, not blown away. A 7-pointer sounds like a blowout with this kind of scoring. 37-34. Okolaja, that jump hook, that's nice.
He's got a beautiful jump hook, Okolaja. Every time he throws it, it looks so, so balanced.
Now Latunda trying to draft traffic, comes off a pick set for him by Gomez. You see that so often, that's basic offense. Calvajo, the old veteran. Oh, Gomez, yes! He goes around Schulze and dunks it.
Well, Schulze took the ball fake baseline. Gomez went straight to the rack and able to finish strongly. He enjoyed that.
Gomez, 2.03 meters tall. Great jumping ability. Nowitzki inside. Schulze overcooks it. Misses a shot. Gets his own rebound. Ball raked out of his hands. And it's going to be Almeida, number 13.
That'll be his second. He's had a really unhappy time in this game, Almeida. He is one of the main men offensively for the Angolans.
Hamann checks back into the ballgame, replacing Green at point guard for Germany. Well, nice touch from Schulze. 4 of 6 from the free throw stripe. 14 of 16 for Angola. That's what's kept Angola in the game. 40-36, 4-point spread. He misses the second, so one shot, 1 point off the two-shot foul. And Angola, if they score two, well, it's plus one to them. Latunda, nice arch. Can't put it down. Mingus knocks it out of bounds.
Well, the Germans are happy with that. They're not overextending themselves, Bob. They're just doing what it takes to stay in the lead. A 1 point win is as good as a 10-point win for them.
Angola, if they cause an upset here, nobody will doubt that they're here and they're for real. Nice little understanding. Schulze takes a nice feed, nice assist from Okalaja, and gets an easy two. 42-36, Angola now have to score. They're under pressure right now. Knocking it around the outside, and underneath it goes Gomez against Schulze. Good matchup here. The jump hook shot, ball hangs tantalizingly on the ring, falls away. Gomez will get two free throws. He's been pretty steady from there.
And that was on Nowitzki, as you see, just rakes the arm there on Gomez. So Nowitzki, that's his second foul. As a precaution, Patrick Femeling will come in to the game. 7-1, 7-2 to replace 7 foot.
Gomez has the first, cuts the lead now to 5 points. Gomez, the only player in double figures for Angola, sitting on 13, Nowitzki on 14 for Germany, in such a low-scoring game, there's little surprise that there's only one player from each team in double figures. Cipriano on 9 for Angola. Nobody really in foul trouble unless you consider Demerol and Okalaja on 3, but it's late in the third period. They've got 2 to give, and Okalaja goes to double figures with that one.
What a lovely little offensive move there. He used the pivot foot a number of times to get people off the ground, waited for everyone to jump around, and then just lay it up. Beautiful basketball.
Almeida kicks it out. What a pass. Cipriano, one bounce to the left. Can't nail it.
That was Cavallo.
It was Cavallo, sorry.
Cipriano's gone to the bench. He needed a rest, all the skywalking he was doing. Schulze for 3.
Do you like that? That's a clutch basket. That's the kind that wins games, 47-38. And now Angola in trouble. They're down 9. They just haven't been able to score. Another miss. Germany, 14-8.
That wasn't even close.
Corner.
That wasn't even close by Almeida. Generally a very, very good outside shooter.
Wow, we're just seeing a little mini choke from Angola here. Offensively, just not able to do the job. And that's the end of the third period with Germany in the waning minutes sort of blasting ahead to a 9-point lead here, 47-38 in the context of the game. That looks pretty comprehensive, but it's not. Anything could happen in the final 10 minutes of play. Well, you look at the shooting percentages there. Angola has really fallen away. The only thing keeping them in the game is their free throw shooting, 16 of 18. Excellent, 90% basically. And their offensive boards, well, they've got nine of them. And Carvalho, the coach, trying to get his players lifted. How do you talk them into a better shooting percentage? If you had that secret, you could bottle it and sell it around the world.
Well, you could certainly sell it to the New Zealanders, because they've had their shooting woes in this tournament.
Or you can shoot shots like that. Pretty high percentages. Gomez just stuffs the basket full. Joaquim Gomez, you see his stats there. Rebounds, 10 for him to go along with his 14 points. A double-double from Joaquim Gomez. Nowitzki has 14 points and rebounds. Well, he's on 7. So one double-double, and that coming from the Angolan player, Joaquim Gomez. Here we go, the final 10 minutes. This game to determine the second-place finisher in Pool B. Spain playing Japan last game, and Pool B tonight. And following this one, New Zealand, a must win over Panama if they're going to go through. Panama, even if they win, they will not go through. 0-4, New Zealand 1-3. That'll be an interesting matchup, and that starts at 4 p.m. Japan time, Hiroshima time. Demerill inside. Okay. Demerill from up top. Well, the Angolans force a stop on the zone. And the running got the two. Mingus, that's great body control. Just when they disappear, they come roaring back like that.
Well, that's the thing that the Germans have got to do. Stick to their game plan defensively. Get back in defensive transition. Stop any break opportunities that the Angolans are going to have, because they're so effective in the open court. And offensively go down the other end and make the Angolans play defense in the half court. Simple game plan, got to stick to it.
Well, they needed the three-point play, I do believe. They missed the free throw. They're still shooting well, 16 of 19, but percentages don't matter now. And Carvalho up off the bench, the foul. Number four, Demerill picks up the foul right
well,
there.
They're saying that Demerill intentionally held the elbow. He's on four fouls. That'll probably bring either Rolab into the game, or they'll just stay with the one point guard in Haman.
9:28 left in the ball game. Germany leading by 7, 47-40. Green Arena filling up in anticipation of game number two. Panama taking on New Zealand. In the meantime, Germany top scorers, three players now in double figures. Femmerling, the big center, still sitting on 6, started the game so well, but hasn't featured in quarters 2 or 3. Joaquim Gomez leading the scoring for Angola. Barros and Cipriano chipping in with 9 each. In the context of the game, 40 points total scored. Well, the majority of points coming from those three players. Germany sitting on 47. This is a low, low scoring game. We've seen a couple of those. 60-57 last night. New Zealand came back from the death to beat Japan with a minute 25 to go. And from the corner, Cipriano knocks it down.
Cipriano's been out of the game a while. Back into the fourth quarter. Nails a three. Brings Angola back to four.
Nowitzki into Femmerling. The two big guys, good understanding. They've been together a long time. Femmerling, nice move. He goes low, comes back high, and gets a little finger roll hook.
Well, Germany sticking with the game plan, even though Angola makes the odd little run here and there. Germany just sticking with their game plan.
Barros, a kick out to Hay. Mingus lights it up. 6 points in a row from three-pointers for Angola. Three-point ball game. It's not over yet. 8.5 minutes to play. Nowitzki averaging just under 20 points per game. He's got 14 in this game. Angola's done a very good job on him. He's not as fired up as you think he might be, given the closeness of the score. Interesting, not a selfish player at all. He'll look for the cutting player. Now he comes to the free throw line. The fadeaway jumper from there falls short. Barros on his bicycle.
But look at the Germans. Four of them back. Now five of them back on transition defense. Just cutting down the offensive opportunities. Great steal here by Okolaja.
That's a great charge.
Barros. That's a charge. And Barros was there. Okolaja has nothing to complain about, just off picture though.
Here's redemption in capital letters. Barros makes a mistake. Watch the hustle. Motoring on his bicycle, he gets there. Plants, boom.
Okolaja, he didn't know what to do. A player of his caliber, you would have thought he'd pull up for the jump shot. That's his fourth foul. He goes to the bench.
Well, Jeff, he's 31 years old, and you just don't have the mobility and quickness that you do when you're 23. Look at that. Mingus from nowhere comes a right-handed scoop shot. Angola right in Germany's face. They're 1 point down with 7 minutes 40 seconds to play.
Well, Germany will go to Nowitzki, as I thought. He'll pull the three.
No, it pops in and out.
And that was off Femmerling on the offensive glass, so Germany clinging on to a one-point lead.
Dirk Bowerman looking up at the scoreboard. Angola on a 10-2 run in the fourth period, made a game of it. 1 point separating these teams. This could be a big, big upset. Germany pasted by Spain in that matchup. They lost by 21. Angola went down by 10 to Spain. Certainly got their respect. Now they're getting the German respect as well. Murray, Gomez, guarded by crafty Patrick Femmerling. Mingus, top of the key, foul. Hamann or Nowitzki?
I'd say that was Nowitzki, yep, it was. Dirk Nowitzki, that's a second foul. Dirkster hasn't scored yet. Only the 2 points, I believe, in the second half.
It's a pretty calm-looking exterior. Hard to read what's on his face or in his mind. He's a total, absolute professional. Eduardo Mingus misses the first free throw. They could be in the lead if they continue to shoot at that hot 90% clip. It's 16 of 20, down to 80. One of two. Tie ball game, 7 minutes to go, and Antonio Carvalho has got to be a happy coach, albeit a nervous one. Well, underneath, Femmerling, he's camped underneath there, and Gomez called for holding.
Yeah, I just like the way that Germany are very controlled. Sure, Angola, they're meeting this run in terms of, well, we know that Angola are a good enough team to make a run at us. But they didn't panic. They came down. They stuck to their game plan. They got the ball inside. Inside-outside game on offense. Taking their time. Not going to do anything silly.
Demon Green, can he hit it from outside? No, but the weak side rebound goes to Nowitzki. He wants it straight back. He gets it. You can see him calling for the ball. Hamann goes the length of the court, has it blocked. But Germany pick it up again. Nowitzki, little spin, that fadeaway jumper. It's not there. Femmerling, he's a beauty.
Patrick Femmerling, the veteran of the German team, just able to get that little bit of jump on Gomez for the tip-in.
Germany by two, 59-41. Angola with possession, 10 seconds on the shot clock. Murray, he draws a foul. Oh, the follow-through gives him the two and one to come.
Well, the coaching staff, the players are up off the bench for Angola. They like that. Murray just took Demon Green. Demon Green came back at him.
Well, Jeff, this is what happens when a superpower, so-called, toys with a pretender, Angola, and suddenly there's hardly any time left in the game, and you're looking at a locked-up score. And, man, the upstarts are gaining in confidence, and the old pros, the Germans, starting to wonder, starting to worry slightly. As Angola takes the lead, 52-51, 6:14 left to play. Hamann sort of nervously drops the ball. Schulze into the game. Very solid forward for Germany, replacing Femmerling. They spell Femmerling quite often. He does get tired. Green inside, Nowitzki. He takes steps. The referee tags him with steps. Nowitzki utters
Nowitzki,
that word.
Yeah, Nowitzki just had the ball, slammed it out of the back of his hand as he walked away. He did travel. It was a good call. The other referee warned him about throwing the ball.
Barros against Hamann. Murray. There he is, Cipriano lights it up. Oh, does he what? Hey, goodbye Germany perhaps. Carvalho, he's a happy coach, and look at the fans.
Well, you watch Dirk Bowman here in the timeout. He'll be speaking German, no two ways about it.
5:39 left to play in the ball game, and Angola have ripped into a four-point lead. Angola on a 17-14 run. Germany is stunned. And they've called a timeout to try to get the train back on the tracks. Well, a fascinating game of basketball. The highlights, here's one of them. Mengus, look at that. A little scoop layup. Comes off the right hand, going closer to the basket with it, and he gets it. Carvalho, did he like that? Unmistakably, a yes. There's another shot of it. And Cipriano from behind, that's what you see if you were courtside, if you were standing behind him. You'd have to say, nice one, Olympio. Splash. As Angola rip into a four-point lead. Field goal shooting. Angola still trailing Germany. Germany have taken more shots. It's the free throw shooting. 18 points for Angola off of free throws. 18 of 22. Every coach's dream. Right, coach?
Well, that's what it's all about. You just got to stick to your game plan. Germany hasn't changed their game plan. You know, they've stuck to it offensively. They've stuck into the half court defensively. Angola has just taken their time to adjust to the half court defense that the Germans are throwing on them. And they've been able to just get a couple of easy looks.
Well, both these teams are going to go through, no doubt about that. But the winner will go through in second place. And in the crossover match, they'll get the third place finisher in Pool A. Ball knocked out of, oh no, it's not out of bounds. Hustle for Murray. The little guard's doing everything for Angola now. Murray, he's played so well. 5 points from him. And no mistakes, really. Cipriano against Garrett. From a long way out, Barros knocked to the floor. He slides well over halfway. That put him in a good transition defensive position.
Oh, Nowitzki tried to go through his legs, and Barros picks it up for the steal.
He's got it. That's cheer hustle. Take your hats off to the little man with a patch over his eye, Milton Barros. 57-51, and Germany nervous, wondering, doubtful, you bet. If he doesn't drill this, and they don't get the rebound, and Nowitzki goes to the deck. Ball knocked out by Gomez.
Well, Nowitzki really giving Demerol something to think about in the next offensive possession.
Well, you give Angola a sniff, and they'll take a second piece of the pie. They're doing it here. The star's on his back, and Gomez is talking to the referee, saying Nowitzki hit it out. But Germany will inbound the ball. 4 minutes, 39 seconds to play. Angola sitting on a six-point lead. That's a crucial possession, I believe, for Germany. Nowitzki out beyond the three-point line, gives it up. Now he calls for it. Gomez right up next to him. Into the corner. Green, they live or die by this three, and they've got it.
Well, they live and die by the fact that Damone Green is able to hit big shots when needed. Patient on the offense, got it inside. Once again, inside-outside game, inside to Nowitzki. Passed it out around the keyhole. Damone Green, easy three in the end.
Well, 4 of 18 from three-point shooting, and Green has two of those. Cipriano, you beauty!
Well,
light
Cipriano,
it up, baby!
That was deep. Michael Ozja just sat way back and under the three-point line, and Cipriano stung him.
Reestablishes that six-point lead. We're under 4 minutes to play. Okolodja. There's 11 seconds on the shot clock ticking down here. Goes inside. And the push from behind on Mingus.
It'll be on Mingus on Nowitzki.
Mingus remonstrating with the referee. Germany have only three field goals this quarter. Remember, it was 47-38 at the break. It's 60-54 now.
Third foul on Mingus.
Mingus leaning against Nowitzki. Demerol passes up the three. They want the ball in this man's hands. He'll do the fadeaway. No, he comes into the paint, and he's fouled before he gets the shot up. So Nowitzki has been on 14 points for minutes and minutes, and he goes to the free throw line.
That's four fouls for Mingus. Eduardo Mingus, he's just not being able to. He goes up and gives Nowitzki five and says, yeah, I've got to do what I've got to do, son. In the post, I've got to push you around. I've got to make you work for it.
Nowitzki knows that. He makes the free throw. He's on 15 points. And he's got his double. He's got 10 free throws to go with it.
10 free throws or rebounds?
Rebounds it is, sorry. 60-56, four-point lead. Correction coming from the coach. The ticking off. Murray lowers his shoulder. That's a charge. Now Angola just losing a little offensive control.
Well, you haven't seen the Germans panic yet, have they? So they're confident in their ability to be able to keep Angola in this half-court set, sort of try and ride the wave and just see what Angola can do. Sure, Angola's up four at the moment, but Demon Green trying to change that. Nowitzki, another offensive rebound and another foul.
And Nowitzki puts up a practice shot while the referees are making the call. Angola lead 22-9 in the fourth quarter. They've just sort of snatched the game out of the grasp of the Germans. They were down by 9 points coming into the final 10 minutes. And we got a timeout taken by Angola. 3 minutes and 6 seconds left. Don't leave your television sets. This is going to be a great finish. Angola leading Germany by 4, 60-56. Highlights, look at Barros, That ball was as good as out of bounds, and the little fella, just such hustle, goes up and makes it two. He stings the Germans with the steal and with the two. You've got to love the hustle. The African champions.
Cipriano, though.
Looking pretty good.
That three was absolutely deep.
Well, Germany came for a picnic in the park, and they're in a real tussle now. Down four, 3 minutes and 6 seconds to go. The African champions just knocking on the door. They're just 3 minutes away from an upset victory here in Pool B. Nowitzki on the line. Now Gomez, standing in the lane, takes his time. Nowitzki, quite properly, is protesting to the referee. The referee's telling Nowitzki just to cool it. Gomez really walked a tightrope there.
Well, he shouldn't have. And Nowitzki. But a gamesmanship by Gomez.
Now with a capital G, Nowitzki answers it. He looks over at Gomez as though to say, didn't put me off at all, mate. Another little look there. And a second free throw to come. This could make it a two-point ball game. It does. Now, oh, Mr. Automatic, Mr. NBA, Mr. Everything, Mr. Planet, Mr. Basketball. Nowitzki is on 18 points. 10 rebounds. He's got his double-double. Another one. Barros makes the move left against Demerol. Just leaves him for dead.
Well, that was a pretty quick offensive move by Barros. Demerol is not a slow man by any stretch of the imagination.
Cipriano comes up trying to make the steal off Nowitzki.
That'll be his third foul.
There's a lot of body contact out there, and I think Cipriano's wrong here. Here it is, the foot speed, pedaling furiously, gets to the line well before Demerol.
And there's Cipriano. He had no show getting the ball there. Fouls Nowitzki back to the line.
Smack.
He's been absolutely tight. Marvelous from the free throw line right now.
Well, he's 6 of 6. Here's his seventh. And Germany now 10 of 13. Free throw shooting in this game has been very, very good. 62-60, 2.5 minutes to play in a ball game. Angola clinging to a two-point lead. It was six just a moment ago. Hey, that's a big shot. That's Mingus.
Well, they can all shoot that medium-range jumper, and the defense was slack there from Germany. You haven't seen it very often, the slack defense.
Barros trips on Nowitzki's foot. Green. Left open for a moment and puts it down. That's clutch basketball. You get the shot, you got to knock it down, and Green answers the call. 2 minutes to play. 2 points separating these two teams. The winner goes through in second place. In Pool B, Mingus. Oh, from the weak side rebound, Nowitzki. And a ball's knocked out of bounds by Gomez, they say. Nowitzki makes a big defensive stopper.
That was a great defensive play by Germany. In particular, here he comes, Dirk Nowitzki, staples it to the glass. Oh, and he did get out of the way, too.
It was a great camera work. We saw it. You saw it. You were right there on the spot. Nowitzki going baseline. He misses a shot. He gets his own putback.
Oh, he's happy.
It's the Dirk Nowitzki show. That ties it up at 64-all. 1 minute and 30 seconds to play. Angola now struggling offensively. Can they answer the call? They've played so well, come so far. Germany just doing enough to stay with them. You get the feeling Germany's a little more comfortable. Oh, oh my goodness me. Yes,
Cipriano,
indeed.
That
Olympic
was
heave from Cipriano.
Like, Haman couldn't play better defense if he tried. That was great defense, but offensively, just perfect.
That's an in-your-face three. Now Germany have got to answer it. 1:04, time ticking down in Green. He's short with it. Mingus. Ball knocked out of bounds by Mingus. He could have grabbed that ball. He could have kept it in bounds. Well, he thought clearly Germany had knocked it out.
Well, three referees all said it was Germany's ball, so.
Nowitzki spins.
And one. That's the quality of Dirk Nowitzki. He got Gomez off the ground, still had the presence of mind, the physical abilities to get the shot up. Here he goes. Gomez is off the ground. Nowitzki tries to go for the and one. Germany are going to have to make a great defensive play here, because even if Nowitzki gets the two, they're still down one. They'll have plenty of time.
Well, Nowitzki is just so steady. That's eight in a row from the free throw stripe. Germany now 11 of 14, 79%, 18 of 22 for Angola. Forget all the stats. We're down to 50 seconds. It's a one-point ball game, possession with Angola. And Milton Baros hounded now by Demiral.
Full court pressure here by Germany.
Time ticking away. A basket here could put Germany under real pressure. We're down to 38 seconds.
Cipriano again.
Shot clock. He misses it.
And Haman.
Oh, yes, way out. Haman loses his cool.
Oh, my goodness. That's a three. Stephen Haman. Watch him come off the... Well, from that angle, you couldn't see it. But I thought Haman had played good defense like he did the time before.
There was contact as he came down, Jeff.
Obviously, he got him with the body.
Here it is. Talk about pressure. This is it. Cipriano on the line. A chance he could put it away here. He misses the first.
So Germany will have a chance to tie. Even if he makes the two.
And don't you like it? Cipriano smiling. He's that relaxed about it all. He's smiling as he stands there, having missed the first one. Here's the second. He's got it. Two-point lead. 36.5 seconds left. A nail-biter here at Green Arena. Well, he makes it two. It's a three-point lead. Germany in possession now.
Tons of time for Germany to make either a good three-point shot or an easy two, try and get a 2+1 from the free throw line, or just get an easy basket and play some good defense and hope they get a steal. Plenty of time. If you're a German fan, if you're an Angolan fan, well, you got to be happy that you got a three-point lead with 35.5 seconds left on the clock.
Well, Cipriano, 4 3-pointers in the fourth quarter. Angola as a team, 5 3-pointers. And here's Dirk Bauermann, coach of the German national team. Highlights here in this quarter, Cipriano, boom.
That was his first three, just came off the screen. Beautiful. Catch and shoot. That's what you want, catch and shoot players off the screen. Great form. Haman played perfect defense, Bob. You couldn't do much more than that. Well, okay. All you could hear in the Angolan timeout was the word Nowitzki, Nowitzki. So Angola knows where the ball's going to go to. Well, I wonder if the Germans do.
And they're not saying foul Nowitzki.
Yeah.
The man is an automatic from the free throw line. Here we go. Scene set, 35.5 seconds. Angola sitting on a three-point lead. Germany in possession from halfway. Clock starts. As soon as somebody inbounds touches the ball, he got 5 seconds to get it in. They just manage it. Nowitzki at the top working against Gomez. Now he comes low, kick out. Demiral steps up. Can he do it? He's got it! Tie ball game!
Demiral with the tie for the three. And plenty of time defensively now. 26 seconds to go. Still at least two possessions for both teams.
I don't know what the stoppage was all about, Jeff. As soon as the shot went in, the clock stopped. People walking around. Now, the referee went over to check something in the scoreboard. Now, there's where the clock stopped. I don't know why. Substitutions now. Defensive stopper team comes in for Germany. That's Green, Schulze.
Well, Herman has got to be careful because you've got to go to the hot men of Angola. Coming off a couple of screens, Cipriano, let's see what they do.
Shot clock and game clock virtually the same. Angola will get the last look in the game if they play their cards right. Barros, 12 seconds, counting down. Nowitzki in a mismatch against Barros. We're down to 6 seconds. What's he going to do? 5 seconds. Here he comes, down the lane, puts it up. We got a charging call.
Offensive charge. Good defense by Herman. He jumps up, grabs Schulze. Barros, he thought he could do it against Nowitzki. He went down the lane. And Herman not only had his feet set, he had a tent set as well.
Well,
and
we
he knows it.
Barros in redemption just a moment ago, and here's Herman into redemption.
Here we go, Rollar.
Could be looking
into the
at
game.
Overtime game, 3 seconds to play. Germany will inbound the ball. It wasn't a shooting foul because Angola were in possession. Here we go over halfway. Demiral into the corner. Gets a good look. It's not there. Shot waved away. No good. Taken after the time expired. And we're into overtime. There'll be 2 minutes of talking, a break, and then we got 5 minutes of overtime. Germany and Angola locked at 69 all at the end of the full-time game. Angola outscoring Germany 31-22 to rip back into the ball game and snatch a tie. So we've got overtime coming up. Okay, Jeff Green, if you're a betting man, who's got the momentum? Cipriano with this three. That's the point at which it looked like Angola was going to steal a win.
Well, I'd stay with the Germans because, like, apart from a couple of minutes in their fourth quarter, where Angola came out and shot the lights out, you've got to say the Germans have been cool. They've been collected about what they've done. They've stuck with their game plan. And I don't believe they'll try and change it. They'll defensively try and stop the fast break and the open floor opportunities for Angola. Offensively, they'll do the same thing. Inside out, get the ball inside first, work the ball around to the outside and see what happens. Angola, for them to win, they have to keep this hot shooting up that they've displayed in that last in the fourth quarter there. And if they don't, the Germans will have them exactly where they want them. Like I say, Angola did a great job coming back. Great job. They should have sealed the win. They didn't. And German efficiency, you've got to say, has got them tied up.
Well, a scene set in the Hiroshima Sports Center, known as Green Arena. The beginning of the overtime, 5 minutes of play. And Angola inbound the ball. Barros against the hero for the moment, little Mitet Demirel, who hit that three-pointer. Mingus, he threads the needle with a pass from outside. That's Cipriano, and Mingus polishes it off.
That was just a straight miscommunication defensively by the Germans. Just as I talk up their half-court defense, it goes to sleep.
And now we're talking about something down on the bench. I didn't see what happened, but the referee's gone over to check. It might be
time. They're just checking the time.
Well, it looks about right. 9 seconds expired in that passage of play. That seems all right.
Whatever it is, there's no problem.
Referee signals okay, and we're underway again. Germany inbounding the ball. after the opening 2 points by N'Golo, back into a two-point lead. Nowitzki's got 24 points now. He's carrying the Germans on his back. Demiral chipping in with that crucial three. He'll spin right. Has the ball raked out of his hands. Good defense. And Murray comes up with the ball and hands it back to Barros.
Well, the Germans are guilty of standing around waiting to see what Dirk Nowitzki's doing right now.
Yeah, it's the Nowitzki show, all right. And when he handles the ball, lots of the Germans just stand around. And Mingus, he's got the first 4 points in the fourth, the overtime period.
Well, he's not waiting around, is he?
No way.
Mingus being aggressive offensively.
The bus is ready to leave. You step on it. Get aboard.
Here we go. Everything's going through Nowitzki's hands. Another opportunity and one. He missed the first layup. He got the offensive rebound. Gomez wasn't anywhere near it. And I think it was Cipriano got the foul in the end. Here we go. Puts it up. It was as if Nowitzki was thinking, I'm going to miss this. The defense has come across. Let me just lay it up nicely in case I miss it. The rebound I should be able to get, and he did. Chance to convert a three-point play.
Yeah, he had presence of mind to just put it on the glass and say, I'll get the putback, which, as Jeff said, he did. So he's got the 2 points. Here's the and one. That guy is automatic from the free throw line. He's 10 of 10. Germany now 13 of 16, 20 of 25
right for Angola. Now, Nowitzki's putting on an offensive show to go with his 12 rebounds and two block shots.
And it's not showboating. It's just all cool professionalism. Murray trying to attack the German defense. Mingus posting up low.
Oh,
Murray,
Mingus
knocked down.
Mingus absolutely hammered someone in the paint. I think it was Damon Green. And you heard the clash of bodies all the way up here.
I think Hamann touched that ball before it went out of bounds, but they've given it over to Germany. He was a very lucky man.
I think Damon Green was just checking on the floor to see if there was any teeth missing, whether there was any lying around.
Germany down by one, but they've got possession. Schulze wasn't looking, gets the, but he recovers in time to get the pass from Hamann.
Clear Nowitzki out again for Nowitzki.
Demiral penetrates. Baseline. The kick out. There it is. Green.
To the shooter.
Good look. And
Damon
he knocks it down.
Green. You just can't leave a guy of that quality open. Not in the crunch.
Barros kicks it out. Cipriano from the corner. Oh, beautiful shooting, both teams.
You can't leave him open either. 26 points for Olympio Cipriano. He's
Do
playing
you
off
love
four
this game.
Fouls. Nowitzki is just on Hamann's case, saying, look, you've got to get some defense there, buddy.
Well, he's doing his best. Hand in the face. He couldn't try much harder. Green steps out and knocks. No, he misses over the basket. Hits the strut, so it's out of bounds. So with a one-point lead, Angola have possession. 2.5 minutes to play. 2:39 to be exact. Milton Barros. Oh, is it a classic matchup? Angola, the upstarts, chasing Germany. A reputed powerhouse from the European zone. Six teams come from the European zone. Germany finished second in the qualifying. Barros down the lane. Oh, the one-handed shot on the right hand. He misses it.
Schulze with the rebound. How did you know it was going to Nowitzki? Oh, Demon Green inside for a three-point play. And Barros, he just can't believe that he
that was
that
clinical.
Won.
That
Demon
was
Green
clinical.
Got the ball. Look underneath. Oh, and a little push there. What was Barros thinking? One, he let Demon Green just sneak in there. And two, then he pushed him. Great play by Dirk Nowitzki to get it to that man, Demon Green, for the three-point play. He makes it.
Let the rabbit out of the cage, left the door open. Green went back door. So now Germany by two, 78-76. Pressure back on Angola. They've got a score. Cipriano, he's had the hot hand. He's been the mighty man the last 10 minutes or so. And inside, the pushing foul is going to be against Green, DeMont Green. And can the free throw shooting from Angola continue at the pace it's been thus far, 20 of 25?
It's four fouls on DeMont Green. Could be a little crucial.
Four
because
players.
Because he is the scorer from the outside, DeMont Green. No ways, two ways about that.
Four players in double figures for Germany. Okalaja 10, Schultz at 10, Green 14, and Nowitzki, of course, with 27. And for Angola, Cipriano with 26, Barros 13, Gomez 14, and Mingus 16. And Murray misses his first. Late in the ball game. And the ice beginning to form in the elbow.
Well, Murray's saying, Haman's got his hands on the air. Is that legal?
I'm sure it
You're
is.
Allowed.
There's nothing wrong with it.
As long as you don't move them around, they take them down.
Well, it made Murray think, talk, distracted him, but he makes one of two. One-point game, Germany now, 78-77, 1:45 and counting down. Overtime, the push-off from Demerl, no whistle. Nowitzki, what's he going to do with it? Well, something you can bet. The spin, he's going to go right. No, he comes all the way on the right side. He gets the two. It's a three-point lead.
Well, see, Mingus is on four, so Mingus can't be too aggressive. But, you know, it's 121 to go in the game. I think you have to be a little bit more aggressive than what Mingus did there against Nowitzki.
Barros goes inside, kicks it out, and Gomez!
Well, what happened there was Schulze went to go help Nowitzki. Nowitzki says, I don't need any help. It was the little man. You just have to stay with your man so he doesn't come to the basket like that. Just miscommunication by the German defense.
Germany by one. The steal. It's ahead. Murray, he's got it. And Angola grabbed the lead again by one. 55 seconds, a timeout taken by Germany.
Total miscommunication by the Germans there, both offensively and defensively. The stitches on the jeans, on the playing uniforms, just coming apart just a little for the Germans.
Yep, derailed momentarily. Angola with 55.4 seconds, make the steal here. And Murray, he goes up and he just very safely puts it in the ball. Get a look on his face. Concentration, you bet. So, Angola lead by one, 81-80, 55.4 seconds to go. Timeout taken by Germany. They'll have possession when time resumes. And there'll be one or two possessions each in this minute, all going according to plan. So, who's shooting hot and who's not? That'll decide this ball game, of course. Angola 12-11 in the overtime, 1 point better than Germany. A lot of scoring in this overtime, and they're on a 4-0 run. The whistle sounds, the timeout is over. We often talk about the pendulum and how momentum seems to swing first one way and there the other. There's the official scoreboard. Hold on to your hats. Basketball at its world championship best. Germany down one to Angola. The upstarts in 2006, and people are believers now. The African champion doing so well.
Bob, I'm going to take a guess. Offensively, the ball will go to Nowitzki.
Oh, Jeff, go out on a limb. Why not? Take a risk, mate.
There you go. All my coaching knowledge came to the fore then.
Gomez, a kick out. Schulze, he'll have it. It's short. Oh, the rebound. Cipriano couldn't hang on to it. Nowitzki, he's in the paint. The jump hook, it's out. It's on the floor. Gomez.
Oh, Angola's got it. And a foul. Nowitzki. He had the opportunity two or three times to convert. He didn't.
And the ball thrown the length of the court to the waiting referee at the other end. The foul now going to the line. Who's it going to be? Gomez I do believe. We'll check you. Gomez has shot 6 of 7 from the free throw line. Can he continue?
Germans take a timeout. It could be a three-point ball game with 28 seconds, a lot of time for the Germans. I don't think they'll panic too much. They'll be concerned that Nowitzki had 3 goes at that opportunity, and all 3 of them drew nothing. Great hustle by the Angolans, as they've shown. Look, there's one.
Ball refuses to drop.
Sorry, that's the end of it. That was the end of it. That was the third time that Nowitzki had a go at that. And they hit the foul. Stop the clock.
Yeah, it was a good foul by Nowitzki. He's the consummate pro, knows he's got to stop the clock. Give them a couple of free throws, but they can only score when the clock's not running. Time running out here for both teams. 28.1 seconds. And you don't know if Angola's in the driver's seat or not. We've got to wait until these free throws are taken.
Well, it could be a three-point ball game, and that's what the Germans will be discussing. If
yeah,
they make both.
Don't bet your house on this.
No, you wouldn't bet your house, but that's what the Germans will be talking about. If he makes both free throws, it'll make it a three-point game, and then they'll draw up a play to try and come down. They've got plenty of time to one, either get 2 or an end one, or indeed a 3-point shot to tie it up, and then they've got a bit of time to play some defense.
Now, will the Germans wave their hands in the air? Yep, Nowitzki does, as does Schultz, and then they drop them. Gomez misses.
Well, it could possibly be a 2-point ball game, or stay a 1-point ball game now.
He misses a second one, but
Mingus
gets a rebound.
He got the rebound over Schulze. Now the Germans have to play some hustle defense and foul.
And Demet Green comes out. Gomez very unhappy with himself, smacks the ball to the floor.
Well, that's critical for Germany because that's Demon Green, he's gone for the game. That's his 5th foul. But that was a basic mistake by Schulze. He should have got the rebound. Because that was too easy. Mingus, a good 4-5 inches shorter than Schulze.
Carlos Murray.
He's not going to worry about it, is he?
No, he's not.
Now the Germans are facing a bigger task. Same scenario, could be 3 down, but with less time on the clock.
Murray, he's got both of them. 20 seconds to play. Germany inbound the ball, plenty of time. And they'll be looking for a 3 or to take it inside, get the 2 and get fouled. Mitat Demirel in the corner, Schulze. They're under trouble, under pressure now. The kick out, Garrett from the corner. It's not there. Knocked out of bounds by Mingus.
Well,
6
Robert,
seconds to play.
Robert Garrett wasn't even close, and he's one of the German shooters.
Yeah, Garrett shaking his head after that attempt.
Schulze, I don't know what he was thinking in the end there. He had a 3-point shot in the corner. He didn't take it.
Time starts only when somebody inbounds touches the ball. There's 6 seconds, 6 desperate seconds for Germany. They're down by 3. Angola on a 6-0 run into a 3-point lead. Nowitzki in the corner. He wants a foul. He puts it up. He's got it! Can you believe it?
Nowitzki!
The pro!
And he's saying, hey, he got my elbow. Would you believe it? Well, of course you would believe it because he's one of the world's greatest. Dirk Nowitzki puts it into the second overtime, and the crowd here are loving it. Whether you're a German supporter, a Angolan supporter, or a Japanese person just coming to watch the game, that's why we love the game. Look at this. Nowitzki, ball fake once, ball fake twice. Gomez couldn't do anything else other than play good defense. Dirk Nowitzki drops it, bottom of the net. Swish! 3 points. Let's go to a second overtime.
Well,
is he a happy camper or what?
32 points from the old pro, the Maverick. And look at him pleading his case. He wanted that one last free throw. He'd like to be out of here. Here we go. 83 all. Scene set. Well, we've had 1 5-minute period of overtime. We'll have another one. And we'll continue as long as we need them. There's going to be a winner in this game.
Do the commentators get paid for overtime? That's what I want to know. Our director, Steve Jamieson, is saying no.
Oh, he's a worried man. We're paid by the word, Jeff. Another 5 minutes. The bill is racking up here. We'll have a big account to present.
Look at that. 32 points, 14 rebounds, 3 assists, 1 block. Shooting at a 40% clip from both the 2 and 3-point line. 100% from the line. One of the world's best players on this planet, Dirk Nowitzki. Shows why.
Which team is going to blink first? This is a standoff.
The German press writers down below us having to rewrite what they were writing.
Fouls might come into it. Demiral and Okalaja both on 4 fouls. Green has already fouled out. Hammond on 4. For Angola, we've got Cipriano on 4 fouls and no one else in foul trouble. So Germany in bigger strife foul-wise than Angola. But here we go, 5 minutes in overtime period number 2, beginning right now with Germany inbounding the ball. Remember, in overtime period number 1, Angola scored the first 4 points. What'll happen this time? Okalaja in the game, he's on 4 fouls. Nowitzki, the old pro, he's saved their bacon. He's in the game, and so too is Patrick Femmeling, kicking the ball around. Nowitzki loses the ball on the dribble. A defensive stop from Angola. Murray kicks it out. Milton Burrows has his shot blocked by Hamann.
Great block by Hamann.
A double dose of redemption for the young man.
Well, he fouled the 3-point shooter, Cipriano, before the first overtime.
Oh,
he gave it straight back to Cipriano.
That's called generosity. Gives it straight to Angola, and Gomez loses the ball out of bounds.
Oh, great defensive play. Nowitzki got his hand to it, and Okalaja. Oh, easy basket for the Germans.
That's the stealthy, sneaky trailer play.
Yep.
Femmeling trailing the play, just glided past Nowitzki, got the pass, and got the easy two. Germany, 85. Angola, 83. Gomez goes to the baseline, goes all the way to the hoop, and he's going to be fouled by Femmeling. It's goodbye, Patrick. Oh, no, he's on 4.
He's only on 4. But Gomez, just too quick for him. He takes him to the hole, finishes up high.
Well, free throw shooting has fallen away a little bit, 23-21, but that time Gomez nails it. Gomez has been pretty good, 7 of 10 from the free throw line. Angola could have won the game had they continued at their 90% plus rate.
The Germans very methodical again with their offense. The game plan hasn't changed. Inside out, no other options. Get it to Nowitzki.
Nowitzki into the corner. Hamann. He misses, weak side rebound, knocked out of bounds by Femmeling, who's standing there arguing the case to no avail.
Patrick Femmeling, he wants to be a lawyer when he finishes, Bob.
Well, he's just lost his first case in that case. Cipriano gives it back to the little general. Barros over halfway. Now Angola will look for probably Gomez, possibly Cipriano, Mingus underneath. Okalaja, the old man, makes a steal. Wacko!
Well, I'll tell you what, that's probably the third time in this game that we've seen the Germans pick that pass off. That little cross-court pass. And all three times, it's been Barros that's throwing it.
Well, the big play comes from Okalaja. That gives Germany the 1-point lead, 87-86. Barros out front. A mental lapse in concentration gives Germany an easy two. We're halfway through second overtime period. Pass to the baseline. It's saved by Murray. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Cipriano throws it. Hey, it's there. Do you believe it? From nowhere comes a big three from Olympio.
Olympio Cipriano. He certainly is an athlete and a shooter.
Is he what?
No time on the clock. The clock was winding down. Comes up with another big play.
Mismatch out front. Murray trying to stay with Nowitzki. Demirel goes inside. He gets a roll. You wouldn't believe it. The little guy saved them once. He possibly saved them again. Scores are locked at 89. Talk about a nail biter. People getting their money's worth here. Well, the players.
You think that Angola would go to the hot hand, Cipriano. He's just standing around.
Oh, nice
great
pass.
Little drive by Barros. Again, Gomez, the recipient of a great drive. Inside the lane. That time again, Femeling leaving his man and no one recovering.
Isn't that great camera work? Takes you right inside the game. You can see the look on Barros's face. He saw the open man. He puts the ball on the floor, and Gomez,
that's just bad,
punishes the basket.
That's just bad defensive rotation by the Germans. If you go and help, help and recover, well, someone's got to come down.
They're double-teaming Nowitzki. Demirel, can he do it a second time in a row? No. The ball in the air. Herburn in the game for Germany now gets the offensive board. 1:23 and counting down. It resets the shot clock. Nowitzki's free for a moment. He misses. Look at the putback. Two guys, Femerling and Okalaja, miss the putback.
Well, Angola have a great chance here to get a 4, maybe a 5-point lead.
Yeah, Germany's in trouble now.
They could
Mingus,
ice this game.
He's going to the glass. He's got it. 4-point lead, Jeff. You called it.
They've got an opportunity to ice this game, and they did right there. The Germans now not only have to come down and score, they're going to have to make a great defensive play out of this timeout after they score. Angola, 4-point lead, doing what they do best. Quick offense, easy baskets.
Well, Mingus delivered an email to Coach Dirk Bauerman with that two-pointer. He said, you better take timeout. And look at the players. Calm, focused. They would dearly love to knock off Germany. Angola.
What's the possible crossover for these two teams? One's going to meet Serbia-Montenegro, I would say.
Yeah, possibly, Jeff. The other one might be, well, it's hard to say, but France is going to be in there somewhere. And either Lebanon or Venezuela. Probably Lebanon with two wins.
Well, we haven't heard it, but now Dirk Bauerman is speaking German in the timeout. He's under pressure. He knows it. His team's 4 down.
Well, a little scene set once again. 1 minute and 1 second left to play in overtime number 2. Angola, compliments of the Mingus two-pointer. The drive to the hoop. Lead by 4 points, 93-89. Hold on to your hats.
Once again, the players have to be told, tuck your shirts in. Little ritual that they've got to go through with the referees, I suppose.
Well, it's all about looking and being cool. Demirel goes around Murray. Little fake. Nowitzki gives it out to Demirel. Can he light it up? No, he doesn't. Ball spiked high, and Germany get another shot. Nowitzki down low. He's going to put the ball to the floor. And he goes in. He gets a two-handed jam. It's a two-point ball game. Ball is kicked out of bounds. That stops the clock at 41.8.
Well, good play by the Germans. They didn't have to go for the three. They were patient, as they have been this whole game. They get the easy two. They'll play some defense. Still 41 seconds on the clock. They'll get another shot at it offensively they don't get the ball here defensively.
The ball wasn't kicked out of bounds. Nowitzki hit it out of bounds. Referee didn't see it. Could have been an unsportsmanlike play. Delay of game. Call it what you will. Murray can't get it. Ball knocked out of bounds by Gomez. So Angola with a two-point win. Two-point lead.
See, that's the Angolan. Too quick on the shot clock. And now they've given Germany a great, great opportunity. One, to either tie the game. or two to win it with a three-pointer. And who's the ball going to go to, Bob? Any bets?
Just out of the hat, a wild guess, Nowitzki. 15 seconds and a foul out front. Maybe not a bad play. Murray is betting on Demerol missing one of these free throws.
Well, as a point guard,
that beats Demerol the heck out of giving it back to Nowitzki. He's on 34 points. So another timeout taken, 93-91. Angola leading by two. And Demerol of Germany shooting a couple of free throws when they come back onto the floor.
As you say, Bob, good move by Angola. Forced Demerol to make both free throws. And if they don't, they have an opportunity to ice the game. Germany will have to come back. If they do miss, they'll have to foul. So it's anybody's game. So even though it's 14 seconds to go, it could be won by either team right here.
So what you're saying, Jeff, is these 14.5 seconds could take anywhere up to 10 minutes to play. Who knows?
Yeah, I'm just looking at my watch. I'm in my tea break.
Well, the Union will have something to say about that.
Could we have triple overtime?
Yeah, we can.
Dirk Nowitzki just asking Coach Bowman, are we fouling immediately?
No such thing as a golden goal in basketball.
It's got to be a winner. That's why you love the game so much.
Okay, here's what's going to happen. Demerol will step up to shoot the two free throws. Angola must make sure they get the board on that second miss, if it is a miss. If he makes the first one and misses the second, if he makes both of them, it's a tie ball game, and Angola have 14.5 seconds to get a very, very good look and win the ball game. There's the first one. It's a one-point game. Demerol, cool as a cucumber. It's a confident look on that face. Makes them both. Here we go. 14.5 seconds. Barros double-teamed, and Nowitzki fouls him. He's going to count on the pressure being too much for little Milton Barros.
Well, at the end of the day, and that's four fouls on Nowitzki, so he can't afford to foul anymore. But they want Barros to win it from the free throw line, so they still have 12 seconds, 11.9 seconds, 12 seconds effectively to have the game winner.
To hit the game-winning three. Drama? You bet. So Barros does his job. One to come. And Angola with a one-point lead, 94-93 over Germany. 11.9 seconds. Don't blink.
Germany will go for the win.
He's got them both. All right, Germany now inbound the ball. Clock starts right now. Right now.
When
here
he
we go.
Touches it.
Demerol penetrates, kick out. Nowitzki, he's going to be fouled.
And he'll go to the line. Third overtime, Bob.
Could be 5 seconds to play. And again, we're right back to where we were a moment ago. Nowitzki will probably make both of these. He's 10 for 10. And if he does...
Well, don't even go there. You'll have the German press come mugging us.
Are you talking about the commentator's virus, are you?
I'm not even going to say anything.
Well, here's the old pro, Nowitzki. 10 of 10. 11 of 11. Doesn't even look like missing. Is this guy cool or what?
You're tempting fate, aren't you, Bob?
Oh, I like a little bit of drama in a basketball game.
The German press are right in front of us. They look at us once in a while.
Don't know why. We're just enjoying a great game of basketball. Barros gets it in. 4 seconds. Can he get up this shot? Running off the glass hard, and we've got another overtime. 95 all. 2 minute break and a third 5 minute overtime period coming in just 2 minutes time. How many times do you see three overtimes? Well, in the New Zealand National Basketball League, we saw two of them this season. They're as rare as hen's teeth, so to speak. Can you believe it? Other games, have long since finished in the other pools. And we're still playing here, game number one of the afternoon. Sun will be setting soon.
Well, there's so much time being taken up with this game. I just looked to the right of me and I can see a couple of the New Zealand players because they're only 30 minutes away from their game. Normally there's about an hour in between games. Triple overtime.
Here's one for the record books. I don't know if this has ever happened in the World Championship before, but Nowitzki with these two free throws ties the game at 95. And then Barros races over halfway. He got a look, but it was from a long way away. It was a sort of a desperation heave. It missed, of course. And so that's why we're in the position we are now. 95 all. And Germany with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players on four fouls. Angola, 1, 2, 3 players on four fouls. They'll be dropping like flies soon. And the second game here due to start in 35 minutes, that'll have to be pushed back a bit. The teams need their 30 minutes of warm-up, and they're not going to get it at the completion of this game. And if it's tied at the end of this, we'll have another 5 minutes of overtime. Can you believe it? Don't you love this game? Get your money's worth.
Well, everyone that's sitting here today has certainly got their money's worth.
Well, we've stopped talking about statistics and what have you. 51% shooting from the two spots, 31% for Angola threes, 9 of 29, and 23, 7 of 30 for Germany. Here we go, overtime period number 3, 5 minutes to play. And Angola just throws a ball away.
Well, Minguez was meant to get the ball in the post, he just walked away.
Angola has scored first in the opening, well, the first of the first two overtimes. Germany could finish it here by scoring first, possibly, in overtime number 3. Okalaja gives it to Hamant, throws it away. Barros pedaling furiously, trying to get up the court, saves it. Cipriano goes to the hoop, kick out in the corner. Murray doesn't drop. And Germany survived that little onslaught.
Angola did what they wanted to do. Quicken up the pace offensively. Got the right person the ball to shoot it. Just didn't drop.
Herber, Okalaja, Schulze, Nowitzki, of course, and Hamann. And a second turnover. Ball's on the floor. Nowitzki calls for it. He's got the three.
Oh, look at him. The
Mr.
fist
Ice.
Pump. The fist pump. No clock on the shot again. And Nowitzki, Mr. All World.
Mr. One in a Lifetime, Mr. All Planet.
39 points for the game.
Mingus, a little finger roll, can't hit it. And suddenly, the complexion of the game changes. That three-pointer gave Germany a 98-95 lead. They've got possession, and they can really steal it from Angola if they make it here. Into the corner, Schulze misses, weak side rebound, Cipriano. Why not give it to Nowitzki every time? Every time, a coconut.
Well, they have, apart from that one. That's the first time they didn't give it to Nowitzki.
Go to the man.
Well, he didn't touch it in the offensive set.
Nowitzki
came up with
just
nothing.
Walks the length of the court, sets up low, and now he comes high. He wants the ball. He's got it there.
He'll operate. He's a surgeon. Oh, that's a foul. He's a surgeon. He went to operate on Gomez. That's his fifth foul. Gomez is out of the game. Joaquim Gomez goes to the bench. 21 points.
And Abdel Moussa replaces him, number 12. Moussa hasn't seen court time for a long, long time. Hasn't scored in the game. Three fouls on him. And a big, big responsibility on his shoulders now.
Because he's going to have to guard Mr. All-World, Nowitzki.
Mr. Universe will steal a term from another sport and just tag it on the forehead of this guy who knocks down his 13th straight free throw. He hasn't missed. He's 40 points. I don't know, Jeff, if you were picking man of the match, say for the German team, who's in contention? The fans. Well, I think that's it, 2:51. I shouldn't say that, 3 minutes to play, but Angola now, 6 points behind the three-pointer, and the three free throws off the fouled three-point attempt. Nowitzki's got them all. Cipriano off the glass. He doesn't get the follow-through. And he goes to the line.
Foul.
Clash of heads there. Herber commits the foul. And on the line, Lutunda back in the ballgame. The old captain, number 14 for Angola. But here come the two free throws, 26 of 34, 76%. It's fallen away late in the game. They could have won it in the fourth period had they continued at their 90% clip. They didn't. And two overtimes later, it's Cipriano bringing them back to within four. 101-97, 2:38 left to play. And who's the ball going to go to? Nowitzki, Schulze. Nowitzki on the baseline. He comes across. Two bodies tangled up. Musa and Nowitzki on the floor. Okolodja throws it, and Musa gets off the floor first to get the rebound.
Well, Germany were trying to get the ball down low to Nowitzki from to operate against Musa. Musa's hurt his ankle. He's limping.
Almeida into the game. He's a three-point shooter, but he hadn't been happy this game. Mengus, 3 seconds on the shot clock, and he goes around Schulze, who fouls him. And Angola now step to the line. Is there pressure or is there what on the Angola shooters?
As long as Germany continue to foul, one, it stops the clock for Angola, but it also puts the pressure on Angola to make the free throws. It was shaky,
they're
but
back.
Mengus will take it.
They're back. Mengus with his second, 2 of 4. He's got it. He's 3 of 5 now, 30 of 38. And it's a two-point ball game, 101-99. If Germany can't score now, we could be looking at another tie ball game. So many ifs, so many possibilities. Nowitzki against Musa. He's going to make a move. Bounce. Musa picks his pocket.
Oh, Musa's done a great job defensively. Could tie the game here. No, they can't. Okolodja.
Lutunda.
What a great,
uncharacteristically
great
throws it away.
Yep.
Heartbreaker. Great move. Musa picked Nowitzki's pocket, and Angola just hand it straight back. Okolodja backing in. He's going to come high. No, the spinner out. He's got two, and it's a four-point spread.
That was pretty. That was pretty. In the crunch of the game, the Germans go up four.
Well, that's old man experienced basketball. Lutunda back to Mengus in the lane. Oh, a running one-hander. Superlative.
Well, they've got to try and attack Nowitzki because he's on four fouls. He's the German offense right now, 42 points. And they're trying to pull that fourth foul on Nowitzki. That fifth foul, sorry.
Germany using up time. We're down to 42 seconds. Okolodja kicks it high. Schulze into the corner. Nowitzki's got the three-pointer from the corner.
Oh,
you can't beat it. He just can't beat it.
He points the shooting iron to the crowd. 45 now, points from Dirk Nowitzki.
Lutunda taking too much time here. He shapes up. He just can't
That's
hit the three.
Game,
That's
Bob.
It.
It's history.
Nowitzki's fouled, and this guy's a machine. Absolute machine from everywhere. 45 points.
The Germans, Mengus, he fouls out. Guarding all Mr. the world. Nowitzki. The Germans 5 points up. With Nowitzki going to the line to shoot two free throws. He's 15 of 15. There it is. The game winner, effectively. He shoots the pointing iron. points, he shows them it's hot.
Points the shooting iron, Jeff. Shoots the pointing iron. Anyway, we know what you're talking about. Nowitzki on the line. He's hit 15 straight.
Tongue twister.
Well, it's been a long, long afternoon. And the players must be feeling it. I'm sure Nowitzki doesn't like expending this much energy in this game.
I was going to say he's missed one.
17 in a row. Nowitzki, 47 points. Angola just have not been able to contain him. Latunda has to give it up. Cipriano goes baseline, goes to the hoop, and he gets a roll. 108, 103, five-point spread, 8 seconds. It's all over. Germany's going to walk away with a win here. Well, not walk away. Lucky in the end.
He took a bus. Hamann took that extra step.
Well,
very entertaining game. 3 seconds on the clock.
Germany won't go near them. 3.1 seconds. Don't even contest it. Almeida on the buzzer misses it. Heartbreaker. Well, not a heartbreaker. You got to say it's tough, but Angola have acquitted themselves so well. Germany got what they needed out of the big guy, Dirk Nowitzki, down the stretch just to win this game in overtime number three. Can you believe it? 108, 103. Five-point win in the end. Finally, as everybody heaves a sigh of relief, the pool match between Angola and Germany, which was anticipated to be interesting, became fascinating and endless as three overtimes were played before finding a five-point winner. Germany will go through in second place in Pool B. Angola will go through in third place, and a fourth-place finisher, well, will probably be decided in the next game. Here he is, Mr. Universe, Basketball Universe. Oh, my goodness me. Awesome. Absolutely awesome, and I do not use that term lightly. The Haka, he's been watching the Maori Haka, Jeff. Germany applauding the crowd, thanking the crowd. Nowitzki has spent so much time, so much energy in this game. He will not have liked that, but he scored 47 points. And Germany finally outscoring Angola 39-34 in the overtime periods. Three of them, 15 minutes of extra time. Angola blowing kisses to the crowd. They know they've done something of historic nature here. I can't remember there being three overtimes in a world championship game before, but my memory doesn't go back to the first of the games. Angola, 52% outshot Germany and 51% three-pointers, 27 versus 27. Could it be any more even? That's where it was lost for Angola. 79% still good shooting from the free throw line, but they had a chance to win it in the fourth period, and they got just a little bit shaky.
Right back.